一方、ミシガン州のデトロイトではテクノポップが大きな発展を遂げていました。電子楽器を使って執拗にダンスビートを反復するこの音楽は特にクラブで大好評でした。その中心人物の一人がデリック・メイです。
Well, I've said that techno is the genocide of music from 20 years ago. I think the reason I would say that is probably because so many different forms of music have evolved from black music. And I mean, with the whole sort of history of what jazz and what happened in the 30s and with the 20s with jazz and with the Duke Ellingtons and the Louis Armstrongs and even the Josephine Bakers, I mean, that was all a form of black progressive music at one point. At one point, that was the techno of its journey, you know, that was the techno of its time.Computer has given us an opportunity to tap into history, you see, in a way that we never could do it before. And that gives us the opportunities to really create our own perspective of what we've been brought up with all our lives. Techno has informed every form of music. I had Depeche Mode in my house a few years ago, on my fucking living room floor. New Order. You know, I've had...people come into my house just to knock on the door to hang out. They wanted to know what the fuck this music was, basically. Where it came from, who was doing it, how could you do it? At the same time, we always admired these type of people because they were to us pioneers.
先進的なテクノサウンドはアメリカの音楽業界からはほとんど無視されていました。それをいち早く評価し取り入れたのはイギリスのグループです。
I never really understood the way that with dance music, where people fought against it. I mean, even in America, when New Order used to go, there was a lot of resistance from you using sequences. People didn't like, Americans didn't like using sequences, which I thought was absolutely ridiculous. I mean, it's a machine, and it just does what you tell it to do. I mean, it has to be written by somebody.
I find the fact that a machine can use a machine to create a piece of music, I find it very, very interesting. And I'd rather see a room full of machines coming out with a great dance track than some boring fat session musicians who are way past the sell-by date playing music that is well, way past its sell-by date as well.
It's sad in the 20th century and in the 90s we have to still go the same bullshit route that other artists have had to go to get acceptance. Black artists, because we're not entertaining bouffant idiots, we have to go someplace else to be accepted, and that's absolute bullshit. If it wasn't for the independence, if it wasn't for the small little dinky little cities and the few little ghetto black guys trying to make music, it would have never happened.As quiet as it's kept, some of these guys will never make a dime. Some of these guys will be poor and die alone. But in the process, they've been the true renegades. And the true rebels always walk alone anyway.
Derrick May が作るような音楽は FM にかかることはめったになく、アーティストの名前もなかなか知られることはありません。彼らの音楽を聴くためには、街の小さなクラブに足を運ぶ必要があります。このシカゴには、テクノサウンドを聞かせてくれるアンダーグラウンドなクラブが数多く存在しています。
The main focus of any great club has always been the dance floor and the sound system. When you take clubs like Continental Bass or The Loft,The Garage, The Warehouse in Chicago. The thing that was being sold at those clubs was the dance floor and the sound system. Those are the most important things. I didn't know very much about a whole lot of the technology. Probably the person that helped me to think about moving into production a lot more seriously was Derrick May. Derrick May gave me my first drum machine. He used to always tell me, you know, you really ought to think about being a producer.
このようなクラブからテクノよりもメロディーを重視したハウスミュージックという音楽が生まれ、 フランキー・ナックルズはその中心人物として活躍していました。
Back in 1989, I was doing a remix for the Pet Shop Boys, Left to My Own Devices. And the song was like 138, 140 beats per minute. And they wanted me to do a house mix on it. And I just thought that was entirely too fast. And the only way I can do with it what I needed to do with it was I needed to slow it down. Say goodbye. I could love you.If I try, and I could, and left to my own devices. I think the necessity of house mixes and remixes on so much music that comes out, especially the rock music, it doesn't always work. Lil Louis Vega just finished remixing a song for Julio Iglesias. And he did a whole house thing. You know, he did the typical Masters at Work thing with it, which, I'm sorry, I don't see Julio Iglesias in here.The first time I actually realized that house had become a worldwide, I guess, quote unquote, phenomena was with Madonna's Vogue.I just looked at that record and what it had done here in the United States, and I just thought, it's legit now.
Back to life, back to reality. Back to life, back to reality. Back to life, back to reality.
1989年、イギリスのクラブから登場したソウルトゥーソウルはハウスにレゲエやファンクをミックスしたサウンドで大人気を獲得。アメリカとイギリスの両方でナンバーワンヒットとなりました。